Hello sir, today we are going to look how to find a point of intersection in a y-shaped linkage. Point of intersection, basically we mean by it that if you have two linkages, that is here as you can see 3, 6, 9, 15, 30 and other is 10, 15, 30. Now 15, 30 is a common point, common linkage hereafter. Then the 15 is the point of intersection. So we have to return that. So for that, firstly we are going to get this question by using a brute force approach. Basically, in this approach we traverse the one linkage and check for each node whether it is present in other linkages or not. And if it is present, then purely returns this data because that is the point of intersection. Let us deeply understand it using the pane concept. Now here the two linkages are 3, 6, 9, 15, 30. This is our linkage 1. Another 10, 15, 30 is our linkage 2. Now we will check for each node. Like first let us start comparing it from 3. Let us check whether 3 is present in this linkage or not. Basically, we are not comparing the data, we are comparing the address of the node, whether they have the same address or not. So we will firstly check it with 10, it is not same. We will check it with 15, not same. We will check with 30, again not same. Now we will proceed to next node, that is 6. Is 6 has the same address as 10? No. Then again for 15, it's no. Then again for 30, it's no. Then we will proceed to 9. 10, no, don't same. 15, not same. And 30, again not same. Now we will check for 15. It is not same as 10, and this has not same, but it is same as the 15. Now basically, the two linked list has the common point as 15 as an intersection point. So we will return 15. Basically, we have to return its data in our function. So we will return that 15. So after that, our function will not work because we have returned its value. So our function will stop working here. Now we are now assuming that the length of this function is 5, linked list is 5 and other linked list is 3. So if none of them is common, then we have to traverse it in 15 times. So basically its time complexity is order of m into n. M is the length of linked list 1 and n is the length of linked list 2. So its time complexity will be order of mn, which is so much high. Firstly, we will see its code, how its code is working. We will basically see its intersection point. We are not interested in checking how we are taking the input and how is output is printed. We are just checking. We are just taking an argument as the head 1, which is the head of the linked list 1, and head 2 as the head of linked list 2. Now we will appoint these pointers to p1 and p2. And why p1? जब तक p1 है हमारा, basically why p1 से we mean that जब तक हमारा ये second linked list exist करती है, तब तक हमने p2 को head 2 दिया हमने, जो कि ये वाला है 10 वाला head 2 दिया हमने. और उसको कंपेयर करा कि यदि p2 एग्जिस्ट करता है और p2 इज नॉट इक्वल टू p1, तो हमारा p2 चेंज हो जाए. फिर वो ऐसे ऐसे करते करते p2 को p2 नेक्स्ट 10 से 15, 15 से 30 आएगा, और 30 के बाद वो एग्जिस्ट नहीं करता, तो ये अपना इसको स्किप हो जाएगा. और एज p1 इज नॉट इक्वल टू p2, देन रिटर्न्स p1 ऑफ p2. p1 का यदि वो इक्वल हो जाता तो हम p1 का डाटा रिटर्न कर देते, वरना p1 के नेक्स्ट पे आ गए, दैट इज 3 की जगह हम अब आ गए 6 पे. 3 की जगह 6 पे आ गए, तो ऐसे ऐसे करता है वो हमारा चलता गया. मान लो वो कोई सी लिंक्ड लिस्ट में कुछ भी कॉमन नहीं है हमारे, तो हम क्या करेंगे उसका रिटर्न -1 कर देंगे. नाउ एज वी हैव ट्रैवल्ड बोथ द लिंक्ड लिस्ट इज टोटल m into n टाइम्स, दैट इज m इज द लेंथ ऑफ लिंक्ड लिस्ट 1 एंड n इज द लेंथ ऑफ लिंक्ड लिस्ट 2. सो इट्स टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी वुड बी ऑर्डर ऑफ m into n एंड स्पेस कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी इज ऑर्डर ऑफ 1. नाउ एज इट इज टेकिंग टू मच ऑफ टाइम, वी नीड टू इंप्रोवाइज इट. सो हाउ वी विल इंप्रोवाइज इट? वी विल इंप्रोवाइज इट बाय यूजिंग आवर अप्रोच 2. In this approach, we traverse each linked list and store the address of each node in the stack. And then, when we traverse each linked list, we will pop out the stack till we reach the last address, same pop out address. And the last pop out address is the required address of the node. So again, we will understand it using the concept paint. Now again, as you all know that we have two linked lists, that is 3, 6, 9, 15, 30 and 10, 15, 30. Now let us give each a name. Address a name. Assuming by that is this has name 1, 2, 9 has 3, 10 has 4 and they have 5 and 6 as their name. By name I mean by address. Now we will take two stacks. This is stack 1 and this is stack 2. And let us name that as P1 and this is as P2. Now we will traverse first linked list now first and pop push its address here, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, in the second list, now we will are going to traverse our second list, and again we are going to do the same. First, we will push the address of 10, then push the address of 15, and then push the address of 30. Now, as both the top are same, it means that they have a common node. Now we will pop up. We will store each address in our new node, that is K. This is our pointer node, and in this we are going to share our node. Store our node. Now let us as the top is 6, we will put 6 here and pop out both 6 from each edge. Now we will erase it. Okay, now both the again has same, then we will just modify it by k, the by k using 5, and now again we will pop out our 5 from here. Sorry, it must be 1 2 3 5 6, not 4 here. So now both the top nodes are different, so it means our common node is 5. So our common node is 5, so we will return its startup, that is 15. Now we will see its code, how we will going to see its coded. Again, we are just seeing the way how to do it, not the complete function, how to take an input and preparing this list. We will take the argument as head1 and head2. Head1 is the head of the first linked list, and head2 has the second linked list second. Now we will take two stacks, k1 and k2, and name the p1 and p2 again as head1 and head2. Now we will traverse the linked list 1 and push its data, and again now we will traversing the linked list 2 and we will traversing its data 2. Basically, we need to traverse linked list 1, storing all the addresses. Now here we are traversing list 2. Showing all the addresses in this. Now p1. Now we will naming our pointer p1 as equals to 0. And we are going to check with the help of this pointer, reinitializing the pointer. Now if k1 जब तक हमारा k1 dot top and k2 dot top equal है, तब हम क्या करेंगे? Popping pop out करते रहेंगे उसे, popping out the nodes having same address. Again storing the last pop out address here. Now we will just k1 dot pop and k2 dot pop. Now we will do if p1 exists, basically if none of them has common, then p1 is equal to 0. If p1 exists, then we will return its p1's data, returning data of common node of first common node, or basically say its intersection point, or we can say its intersection point. Session point. Now here we are returning -1, and the time complexity of this program is order of m+n. Basically, we are traversing firstly this linked list and then this linked list. So we are just traversing both the linked list monthly. So it's order of m+n time complexity. M where m is the size of linked list 1 and n is the size of linked list 2. Also, we are storing the address of each linked list in a stack. So basically, it is going to take our auxiliary space, which is the extra space that is consumed by our program this, so its time complexity is also order of m plus n, basically storing the address of all the nodes of p1 linked list 1 and storing all the address of node of linked list 2. So it is also, so it is going to take our order of m plus n time complexity as well as order of m plus n space auxiliary space complexity. Now we have in our first approach our time complexity is order of m into n, so we have improvised it to order of m plus n, but we have done it in the cost of our space, because in the our approach one, that is our brute force approach, our space complexity is order of 1, but here our it is order of m plus n, so we are again going to improve it. So let's see how we will going to do it. This is our approach 2 using stack. Now we are going to do it using our approach 3. Now in this we are going to use our difference of nodes. So what we are going to do in this approach, we will traverse more than this, calculate the length of each link list. Now we will change the difference of calculate the difference of number of nodes in both the link list and travel number of nodes in the bigger link list, and now both the link lists are equidistant from the point of intersection, and now we will travel both the link lists simultaneously and the address of nodes for both the link lists become same. Let us understand what we have explained here. Now this is our two link lists. We will calculate the length of each link list. So length of this first link list is 5 after calculation, and the length of our link list is 3. Initialize. Now the difference of the length of the nodes is 2. So now in the bigger link list, that is our first link list 1, we will initialize two pointers, that is here let's name its pointer as p, or we will say that we will take two pointers p and q, and the initialize to the head is 1 and head 2, that is 3, and here it is 10. Now in the bigger link list, we will traverse the number of nodes as here, so we will traverse two now times, that is 6 and 9. Firstly it becomes to 6 and then it comes to 9. Now our first pointer, that is p pointer, points to points here, and our second pointer points here. Now both the pointers are equidistant from the intersection point, that is 15. So we will traverse both the pointers at simultaneously, that it reaches 15 and then the other also pointer reaches 15. Now if both the pointers become same at a instant, then the length of the point of intersection is that. No. Now 15 is the point of intersection here. So 15 is the point of intersection, and we are going to return our 15 as the data, which is the data for point of intersection. Now let us see its code. Now first we will calculate the calculating the length of each link list, that is c1 and c2 is denoting the length of link list 1 and link list 2 respectively. Now by p1 jab tak hamara p1 exist karta hai uski length ko c1 ko baar baar increase kar increment karte rahenge by 1 and similarly increase 2. Now we first we will what we will do, we will store its difference in our new node d and reinitializing p1 and p2 to head 1 and head 2. If c1 basically is I will just write here function to calculate length of link list 1, function to calculate length of link list 2, storing the calculating the differences in the number of nodes of length of each list, reinitializing the pointer. Now if our c1 is greater than c2, it means that our link list 1 is greater, so just traversing that number of nodes, like we are traversing here 3 to 9, just we are traversing that. Else if c1 is not greater than c2, then c1 is equal to c2 or c1 is less than c2, then we will traverse in the second link list, traversing the number of nodes in bigger link list. नाउ जब तक हमारा पी वन एंड पी टू एग्जिस्ट, दोनों एग्जिस्ट करते हैं, पी वन नॉट इक्वल टू पी टू है, लाइक हियर दैट इज हियर इट इज पॉइंटिंग टू 9 एंड इट इज पॉइंटिंग टू 10, वी आर जस्ट ट्रैवर्सिंग द बोथ द पॉइंटर्स साइमल्टेनियसली, ट्रैवर्सिंग बोथ द पॉइंटर्स एट द सेम टाइम, एट द सेम टाइम टिल आवर वन लिस्ट वन ऑफ LL become empty. Comes to end. All our pointers become same. Become same. And now, if P1 and P2 exist करता है हमारे दोनों, तो हमारा क्या होगा? P1 का डाटा हम return कर देंगे और otherwise return minus one. Now in this case, we have traversed each linked list once. And secondly, two ones. So we have traversed both the linked list for once to get the length of the linked list, and again we have traversed a linked list that is to check the point of intersection. So in this, we have also taken order of m plus n time complexity, where m is the length of linked list one and n is the length of linked list two. Order of m plus n, and but here our space complexity becomes order of one. And we have not taken as too much extra auxiliary space, which is depending on our variables, so that is order of one. Now the same function we have can done in very very many different approaches, like in the approach we have used our stacks, we can also done it by using the hashing, and like we have used here difference of nodes in our approach 3, we can do it by calculating the length of each nodes and then reversing the linked list, reverse both the linked list and then calculating the length, and by making the equations we can solve it. Or we can do it in one more approach, or many approaches there like this, but I will just give a brief of one more approach, that by making a circular linked list of the linked list one and calculating the length. All these approaches will take order of n plus n time, and they are similar to our approach 3, and this is the complete code of our approach 3.